Now, a Scottish teenager who's due to give birth in January has been told her baby is likely to be taken away soon after it's born. 17-year-old Kerry Robertson, who has learning difficulties, has already been prevented from getting married because the authorities believe that she lacks the mental capacity to consent to the ceremony. Now, in a moment, we'll be talking to Mark Goldring of MenCap. First, though, let's hear from Kerry herself and her boyfriend, Mark McDougall.
As soon as we found out that Kerry was pregnant, we obviously decided we wanted to do it all properly, get married first, and basically show that commitment to each other.
Mark was like, aye, they're going to take the burden away for us. And I was, like, upset.
What Five Council have done is they've continually discriminated against Kerry just simply because of her learning difficulties, and it seems to be the only issue that they want to talk about. They don't want to look into the fact that Kerry's a loving, kind person who's going to be a great mum. Oh, don't worry about it. It's a lot of pressure, I know, but...
Oh, it's incredibly sad, isn't it? Well, we've had this statement from Fife Council, that's the council that are involved, and it reads like this: much of the work that we do is governed by legislation. Complex decisions are made that balance risk and welfare while supporting people at times of personal and also family need. We cannot discuss details of individual cases for reasons of confidentiality, but give assurance that we will always work with people for the best outcome for all involved. Well, as we said earlier, Mark Goldring from the learning disability charity MenCap joins us to have a chat about this case. And Mark, it is, isn't it? Very, very difficult situation. You can't help but watch that and feel very, very sympathetic towards Kerry. But I suppose this is about whether Kerry has the sufficient mental capacity to look after her child. And I suppose Fife Council are the best place body to make that decision, are they not?
Well, I believe the positive news is that Fife are now insisting they haven't yet made that decision, and they will look at all the facts and circumstances. But it's really important that they do that, and we hope they'll do that, from a starting point of trying to keep the family together. That will be the best outcome, and if they give Kerry good support right from the beginning, if they use the time to plan the support rather than the taking away, there's a much greater chance that she can stay and look after her child.
So you believe that the baby's best situation is to stay with Kerry, but Kerry's going to need a lot of support in order for that to happen. What kind of support are you talking about? 24-hour care? And who is going to fund that, do you think? Yeah.
The cost of any kind of care and support, indeed of fostering and adopting, is very high. The issue, we can't judge whether the baby is best left with Kerry from the facts that we know at the moment. We hope Fife were looking at that very seriously. But the starting point should be, is it possible to keep the child with the family? And of course, not just to look at Kerry, but to look at the support she also gets from her partner and from her wider circle of family and friends. If they look at that, the levels of support that she'll need will often be preventive. They'll be helping not to get things wrong rather than the huge cost of putting things right when they do go wrong.
It's interesting you mentioned family, because we know that Mark and Kerry haven't been allowed to get married.
Yeah.
Authorities have actually stopped them doing that. But Mark is the father.
Yeah.
He doesn't seem to have many rights in this situation.
No.
Does that surprise you?
Well, there should be a presumption of capacity under the law unless it can be established that that person can't consent. Fife would have to be very clear that Kerry can't consent and doesn't understand what she's doing by getting married. Now, that's a strong test to be passed. We see many people with a learning disability who do get married, do have relationships, do have children and become great parents, but half of people with learning disabilities have their children taken into care, and we believe that many of those situations would be avoidable with relatively modest levels of support.
So Kerry's situation unfortunately isn't uncommon. You work with cases like this a lot.
There's nearly a quarter of a million parents with a learning disability in the UK, where one parent or other may have a learning disability. Half of those children are taken away.
So what is the best way forward, do you think, for Kerry and Mark?
It's planning support. If there's something we don't know about, it'll come out in due course. But on the facts as we see them, it's looking at what support is possible, planning it from the beginning and helping her to get things right. That's respecting her human rights, and it's actually helping society.
Okay, Mark, we appreciate your views. Thanks for joining us. Mark Goldring there from MenCap.